Where were you when the world stopped turning on that September day? Were you in the yard with your wife and children, or working on some stage in L.A.? Did you stand there in shock at the sight of that black smoke rising against that blue sky? Did you shout out in anger and fear for your neighbor, or did you just sit down and cry? Did you weep for the children who lost their dear loved ones, pray for the ones who don't know? Did you rejoice for the people who walked from the rubble and sob for the ones left below? Did you burst out with pride for the red, white, and blue, and the heroes who died just doing what they do? Did you look up to heaven for some kind of answer, and look at yourself and what really matters? I'm just a singer of simple songs. I'm not a real political man. I watch CNN, but I'm not sure I can tell you the difference in Iraq and Iran. But I know Jesus, and I talk to God, and I remember this from when I was young. Faith, hope, and love are some good things He gave us, and the greatest is love. Where were you when the world stopped turning on that September day? Teaching a class full of innocent children, or driving down some cold interstate? Did you feel guilty 'cause you're a survivor? In a crowded room, did you feel alone? Did you call up your mother and tell her you loved her? Did you dust off that Bible at home? Did you open your eyes and hope it never happened? Close your eyes and not go to sleep? Did you notice the sunset first time in ages, speak to some stranger on the street? Did you lay down at night, think of tomorrow, go out and buy you a gun? Did you turn off that violent old movie you're watching and turn on I Love Lucy reruns? Did you go to a church and hold hands with some strangers, stand in line and give your own blood? Did you just stay home and cling tight to your family? Thank God you had somebody to love. I'm just a singer of simple songs. I'm not a real political man. I watch CNN, but I'm not sure I can tell you the difference in Iraq and Iran. I know Jesus, and I talk to God, and I remember this from when I was young. Faith, hope, and love are some good things He gave us, and the greatest is love. I'm just a singer of simple songs. I'm not a real political man. I watch CNN, but I'm not sure I can tell you difference in Iraq and Iran. But I know Jesus, and I talk to God, and I remember this from when I was young. Faith, hope, and love are some good things He gave us, and the greatest is love. And the greatest is love. And the greatest is love. Where were you when the world stopped turning on that September day?
Welcome to Abiding Presence Faith Community for Divine Worship for the 25th Sunday, or 24th Sunday, of the Christian year. We ask those about liturgical rules silence their microphones. Our celebrant will be Bishop William R. Cavins. The intention of today's liturgy, we remember all who lost their lives in the attack of September 11th. We start our celebration. Please join us in singing our national anthem. Our original hymn today is number 830, City of God.
Awake from your slumber. Sleep. A new day is dawning for all those who need. The people in darkness have seen a great light. The Lord of our longing has conquered the night. We are sons of the morning. We are daughters of day, the one who has loved us has brightened our way.
Let us build the city of God, may our tears be taken to the sea, for the Lord, the light of the law, has turned the night into day.
God is light. In Him there is no darkness. Let us walk in His light. His children walk in
comfort my people, make gentle your words, proclaim to my city
the day of her birth.
Let us build the city of God, may our tears be unseen,
In the name of God, the creating Father, and of the redeeming Son, and of the life-giving Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of God who raised Jesus from the dead be always with you.
And also with you.
In today's Gospel, we hear the parable of the prodigal son, perhaps better called the parable of the merciful father. Knowing that God is abundant in mercy, we call to mind our own sins and ask God for healing and forgiveness.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. God, the Father of mercies, has reconciled the world to himself and sent the Holy Spirit among us for the forgiveness of sins through the ministry of the Church. May God grant you pardon and peace, and I absolve you of your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Nature is always to forgive and to show mercy. May we serve you with all our hearts and know your forgiveness in our lives. We humbly implore you to continue to defend us from every attack and be pleased to banish violence swiftly from our midst. Bring us to the dignity which distinguishes the poor in spirit and show us how great is the call to serve, that we may share in the peace of Christ, who offered his life in service to all. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your only begotten one, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Let us be attentive.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses, "Go down at once to your people, whom you brought out of the land of Egypt, for they have become depraved. They have soon turned aside from the way I pointed out to them, making for themselves a molten calf and worshipping it, sacrificing to it and crying out, 'This is your God, O Israel, who brought you out of the land of Egypt.' I see how stiff-necked this people is," continued the Lord to Moses. "Let me alone then, that my wrath may blaze up against them to consume them. Then I will make of you a great nation." But Moses implored the Lord, his God, saying, "Why, O Lord, should your wrath blaze up against your own people, whom you brought out of the land of Egypt, with such great power and with so strong a hand? Remember your servants, Abraham, Isaac, and Israel. And I swore to them by your own self, saying, 'I will make your descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky, and all this land that I promised, I will give your descendants as their perpetual heritage.'" So the Lord relented in the punishment he had threatened to inflict on his people. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the first letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I am grateful to him who has strengthened me, Christ Jesus our Lord, because he considered me trustworthy in appointing me to the ministry. I was once a blasphemer, and a persecutor, and arrogant, but I have been mercifully treated because I acted out of ignorance in my unbelief. Indeed, the grace of our Lord has been abundant, along with the faith and love that are in Christ Jesus. This saying is trustworthy and deserves your full acceptance. Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Of these, I am the foremost. But for that reason, I was mercifully treated, so that in me, as the foremost, Christ Jesus might display all his patience as an example for those who would come to believe in him for everlasting life. To the King of ages, incorruptible, invisible, the only God, honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Deacon, may the Lord God be upon your mind, upon your heart, and upon your lips as you worthily proclaim his gospel. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
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 The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Tax collectors and sinners were all drawing near to listen to Jesus. But the Pharisees and the scribes began to complain, saying, "This man welcomes sinners and eats with them." So to them he addressed his parable. "What man among you have 100 sheep and losing one of them would not leave the 99 in the desert and go after the lost one until he finds it? And when he does find it, he sits on his shoulders with great joy, and upon his arrival home, he called together his friends and neighbors and said to them, 'Rejoice with me, because I have found my lost sheep.' I tell you, in just the same way, there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents over the 99 righteous people who have no need of repentance. Or what woman, having 10 coins and losing one, would not light a lamp and sweep the house, searching carefully until she finds it? And when she does find it, she calls together her friends and neighbors and says to them, 'Rejoice with me, because I have found the coin that I lost.' In the same way, I tell you, there will be rejoicing among the angels of God for over one sinner who repents." Then he said, "A man had two sons, and the younger son said to the father, 'Father, give me the share of your estate, that you shall come to me.' So the father divided the property between them. After a few days, the younger son collected all of his belongings and set off to a distant country. And when he squandered his inheritance on life of dissipation, when he freely spent everything, a severe famine struck that country, and he found himself in dire need. So he hired himself out to one of the local citizens, who sent him to his farm to tend his swine. And he longed to eat his fill of the pot in which the swine fed, but nobody gave him any. Coming to his senses, 'How many of my father's hired works have more than enough food to eat? But here I am, dying from hunger. I shall get up and go to my father, and I shall say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I no longer deserve to be called your son. Treat me as you were one of your hired workers.' So he got up and went back to his father. And while he was still long off, his father caught sight of him and was filled with the whole compassion. He ran to his son, embraced him, and kissed him. His son said to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I no longer deserve to be called your son.' But his father ordered his servant, 'Quickly, bring the finest robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. Take the fattened calf and slaughter it. Then let us celebrate with the feast. Because the son of mine was dead and has come to life again. He was lost, but has been found.' Now the celebration began. Now the other son, who had been out in the field and on his way back, as he neared the house, He heard the sound of music and dancing. He called the servants and asked what it might mean. The servant said to him, "Your brother has returned, and your father has slaughtered the fattened calf because he had him back safe from sound." He became angry, and when he refused to enter the house, his father came out and pleaded with him. He said to his father in reply, "Look, in all these years I've served you, and not once did I obey your orders. Yet you never gave me even a young goat to feast on with my friends. But when your son returns, who swallowed up your property with prostitutes, for him you gave him, you slaughter a fatted calf." He said to him, "My son, you are here always with me. Everything I have is yours. But now we must celebrate and rejoice because your brother was dead and come back into life again. He was lost, but had been found." My brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. May the words of the gospel wipe our sins away. Perhaps you're familiar with the saying, "Those that do not study history are doomed to repeat it." And in our society today, I would suggest to you that we are making the mistake of repeating history. As you heard in the first reading, Moses is up with God receiving those Ten Commandments. And the Hebrew community at the foot of the mountain can't understand what's taking so long. And they lose heart, they lose faith. So much so that they revert back to some of the practices that existed in Egypt, and they created a golden idol and started worshiping it with all the necessary Egyptian practices that went around to worshiping that golden bull. And God found it to be depraved. In our society today, even though, like those Hebrew people who have had the experience of God's love for them as they left Egypt and were protected against attack, passed through waters to safety, couldn't wait for God's revelation to them. Our society is very much like that today. We create perhaps not golden calves, but we have people in our society that worship politicians, that set them up above God. We have others that are consumed with getting as much money into their hands as possible. Still others look at other ways to grasp at celebrityhood or other vain glories. Until they reach a point in their life where they suddenly recall that there's something missing out of their life. They're missing that spiritual aspect, that relationship with God. Some despair that they'll ever get it back. And in that despair, condemn themselves. Yet there are others that turn around And in their own minds, they think they're seeking God. But in reality, as we heard from both Paul and in the gospel today, God's there meeting us. Paul refers to himself as one of the greatest sinners. And yet Christ comes to him and changes his heart. And he turns around to become one of the great apostles and writers. You saw how the shepherd and the widow searched for something they had lost, and how great their joy was when they found it. And then we go into this parable of the merciful father. And true, it is the son who decides, the wayward son decides to come back. But even at a great distance, the father sees him and comes out to the son. He comes out to his other son as well later on. That is what God is for each of us. He is here reaching out to us, waiting for us to make up our minds to come back. Waiting for us to discover that no politician is worth throwing away your values and beliefs. No amount of money is going to grant you eternal life. No matter how famous you are, in death we are all the same, and before God we are all the same. Today is a day for us to think about the mercy and the compassion of God. Some would argue that, oh, but God permitted 9/11 to happen. And I would say to you in response, have you forgotten about human free will? If we were exercising our free will in the manner that God expects of us, to be truly concerned about the welfare of others, 9/11 probably would never have happened. Now, there's always going to be somebody out there that's going to do some sort of harm, for whatever reasons, because in our humanity we're flawed. But God uses these occasions to bring us together again, to remind us that there's something greater, even the most horrific events. So today, as we recall the lives that were taken from us and the great potential that those lives represented in this world, as we hear about God waiting for us to come back to Him, let's take this occasion to recommit ourselves to living gospel values of love and true concern for all. Let us profess our faith together by reciting the Apostles' Creed as found in your order of worship. I believe in God, eternal, almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, the Redeemer of all, the only begotten One, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, lived and loved among us, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried, who descended into hell, and on the third day rose from the dead. Jesus, our Savior, ascended into heaven, sits at the right hand of the loving God, and will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Knowing that God sees each of us while we are still a long way off, we can confidently raise our prayers, knowing that they will be heard.
Our response will be, as we remember, Lord, hear our prayer.
As we remember, Lord, hear our prayer.
For our nation, let us remember all those that fell in 9/11, and we use wisely and well the freedom that so many have helped keep alive and safe by the sacrifice. Let us pray.
As we remember, Lord, hear our prayer.
That all people in leadership roles might celebrate the inherent worth and dignity of all people that serve regardless of their status. Let us pray.
As we remember, Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prodigal children who wandered far from God, especially those among our own loved ones, that a great impulse of grace may draw them back and will be welcomed with abundant joy and radical hospitality. Let us pray.
Remember, Lord, hear our prayer.
That our church might be a safe place for all people, including immigrants, refugees, and those fleeing abusive relationships, and members of the LGBTQ community. Let us pray.
As we remember, Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who become disoriented through heavy burdens and sufferings of life, that the Divine Shepherd may find them and carry them gently to healing and peace. Especially Father Bob Giannini, Bishop Doreen Noble, Michael Smith, Edward Turk, Michael Agnostinis, Charlotte Glover, Stephen Strobel, Bishop James Allen Wachowski, Deacon Christopher Larsen, Nick Eggert, Andy Wachowski, let us pray.
As we remember, Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faithfully departed ones and those close to death, that the grace of our Lord may be abundant for them, bringing them mercy and a place at the heavenly feast of reconciliation and joy, especially Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and the 2,977 victims of the 9/11 attacks. Let us pray.
As we remember, Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, you are kind and abundant in mercy. Hear us as we call to you, for we know you rejoice in our presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The offertory hymn is number 568, Where Love is Found.
Sisters, that this our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Creator.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice in your hands,
for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and glory
of all the Church.
Lord, hear the prayers of your people and receive our gifts. Be mindful that your only begotten One, who himself is peace, has destroyed our hatreds by his blood. Look with mercy on our evil deeds and grant that to those whom you love, this sacrifice may restore peace and tranquility. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. For it is at your summons that we come to birth, by your will that we are governed, and at your command that we return, on account of sin, to that earth from which we came, and then give you the sign we have been redeemed by faith at you, by the death of your only begotten one, shall be raised up to glory of his resurrection. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, and without end we acclaim. Truly blessed, O God of holiness, you accompany us with love as we journey through life. Blessed too is your Christ Jesus, who is present among us and whose love gathers us together. As once he did for his disciples, Christ now opens the scriptures for us and breaks the bread. Great and merciful creating Father, we ask you now to send down your Holy Spirit to hallow these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the eve of his passion and death, while at table with those he loved, he took bread, he gave you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks. He, handing the cup to his disciples, said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." Great is the mystery of faith. So, Father Creator, most holy, we celebrate the memory of Christ, your only begotten One, whom you led through suffering and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection and a place at your right hand. Until Jesus, our Redeemer, comes again, we proclaim the work of your love and we offer you the bread of life and the cup of eternal blessing. Look with favor on the offering of your church, in which you show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ entrusted to us. Through the power of your Spirit of love, include us now and forever among the members of your Son, whose body and blood we share. Strengthen in unity those you have called to this table, together with the patriarchs of the East and the West, Chris, our presiding bishop, Bill, our diocesan bishop, and all bishops, priests, and deacons, and all your holy people. May we follow your paths in faith and hope and radiate our joy and trust to all the world. Be mindful of our brothers and sisters who fell on 9/11 in the peace of Christ and all the dead whose faith only you can know. Lead them to the fullness of the resurrection and gladden them with the light of your face. When our pilgrimage on earth is complete, welcome us into your heavenly home, where we shall dwell with you forever. There with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles, the martyrs, and all the saints, we shall praise you and give you glory through, through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through Christ, with Christ, in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Creator, forever and ever. Turn to our creating Father in the words that Jesus himself taught us.
Our Father, who art in
Lord, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ.
The power and the glory are yours. The kingdom, the power and the glory are yours. The kingdom, the power and the glory are yours.
Told your apostles, "The peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
And also with you. Let us give up all and sign of God's peace.
Peace be with you, Deacon. Peace be with you. And peace with all of you viewing.
Take away the sins of the world.
This is the risen Christ, the Prince of Peace, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper. Lord, as I take communion, I recommit my life, my heart, my thoughts, my everything to you. We offer this prayer for those that are unable to receive communion with us today. Lord Jesus, I believe you are always present in the Eucharist. I love you with my whole heart. I want you to be always in my soul. Be with me, please, in spirit, though I cannot receive communion today. Keep me close to you always, as you promised. The table is prepared. Come, eat, and drink.
Our communion hymn is number 563, Show Us Your Mercy.
Show us your mercy, come soon.
Our hymn of thanksgiving is number 739, Let There Be Peace on Earth.
Let us pray. Lord, you are always faithful and quick to show mercy. Your word and your sacrament give us food and life. May we successfully overcome the fury of war and resolutely keep your law of love and justice. Our brothers and sisters we remember today were suddenly taken from us. Have mercy on them and comfort their family and friends by the power and the protection of the cross. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
We at Abiding Presence keep this Wednesday, September 14th, as a holy day of obligation, marking the exaltation of the cross. Divine worship will be at 6:30 p.m. James Michael Brown Crockpot Ministry is utilizing this summer break to test recipes and stockpile crockpots. I guess there's some crackpots out there we can stockpile too. We hope to host our first class sometime this month. To donate a crockpot or to volunteer to conduct a class, contact Dennis Last. I'm sure there are a lot of things going on right now in all of our lives. And it's good to take time today to spend time with family and friends. We extend our deep sympathies to the royal family in England. This has been made known by so many of the commentators. Elizabeth II was really queen of the world. All of us have some memory or thoughts about the example of duty that she set for all people. So try to have a care for for your own families today and your duty to them and to one another. The Lord be with you.
And also to you.
Also with you. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing.
God of mercy and consolation, you pursue us with untiring love and dispel the shadow of death with the bright dawn of life. Comfort your family as they remember those who they lost and deal with their ongoing sorrow. Be our refuge and our strength, O Lord, and lift us from the depths of grief in the peace and light of your presence. Your only begotten one, our Lord Jesus Christ, by dying has destroyed our death and by rising restored our life. Enable us, therefore, to press on toward him so that after our earthly course is run, he may reunite us with those we love when every tear will be wiped away through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Amen.
Amen. Go in peace to love and serve God and each other.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing hymn is number 715, Through the Mountain, Though the Mountains May Fall.
Could the Lord ever leave you? Could the Lord forgive his fault? Child, he will not abandon you.
The mountains may fall and the hills turn us, yet the love of the Lord will stand as a shelter for all who will call on his name. Sing the praise and the glory.
Should you turn and forsake him, he will gently call your name. Should you wander away from him, he will always take you back.
The mountains may fall and the hills turn to dust, yet the love of the Lord will stand as a shelter for all who will call on his name, sing the praise and the glory of God.
As he swore to your fathers when the flood destroyed the land, never forsake you, he will swear to you again.
Though the mountains may fall and the hills turn to dust, yet